I want to tell you about my absolute favorite tool with TubeBuddy, Best Practices. This is a fantastic tool, so stick with us. We're going to show you how to use it and all the good it can do for your YouTube channel. So, I've already spoken a little bit before about how it works in the Videolytics tool, but let's review that again. As you see here on the right-hand side, whenever you're looking at a video, whether it's your video or someone else's, you can see if these 8 best practices have been followed. Did they upload a high-resolution thumbnail? Are there info cards and end screens added? Has it been shared on Twitter, Facebook? Have captions been added? Was a comment pinned? And was a comment hearted? So, this is a fantastic tool you can use on your videos and other people's videos. But that's not all the best practices does. In fact, you get best practices on your video upload screen and in your video edit screen that, instead of these 8, has 14 best practices if you have the paid version of TubeBuddy. If you have the free version of TubeBuddy, you'll get 3 on those screens. When you're editing a video, in the bottom right-hand corner, you'll see the Best Practices box that is part of the TubeBuddy browser plugin. If you don't have that, I highly recommend you install it using the link down below. This box will display the best practices that have not yet been completed. And you can actually click to see all of them, including the ones that have been completed, but it's nice that it focuses on the ones that are still outstanding rather than the ones you've already done. So you can click Show Completed to show the full list. As you can see, there are 14 best practices here, and on this particular video, many of them have been completed, such as pinning a comment, adding the video to a playlist, adding an end screen, hearting a comment, and replying to a comment. I find this reminder incredibly important. There are so many small things to do on YouTube that it's easy to forget them as you're going through your workflow. I've said before many times that success on YouTube isn't about knowing one particular trick. It's about 100 little things that you do, and that's a lot to remember. So 14 of them are right here, just waiting to remind you to make sure that those are done to give your videos their best chance for success. So what I've shown you so far was in the classic version of Creator Studio, but this function does also appear in the new beta version. Now you'll see here that it actually only has 13 best practices, rather than the full 14 in the beta version, so I still prefer using classic for this, but updates to this will probably come in time. But again, the display in the interface is very similar to the classic version. There's virtually no difference. I mentioned earlier that there are only 3 best practices that appear on the edit video screen when you have the free version of TubeBuddy. As you can see here, since none of them are listed, I've completed all 3 of those, and there's one other out of the full 14, but unfortunately I would need to upgrade my TubeBuddy license to see all of them. I do highly recommend getting the upgrade. And here you can see the free version in Studio Beta. And so again, the 3 free ones have been completed, so the list is not showing anything specific that needs to be done, because I've already done the free ones, but there are 3 that I've missed that I would know if I had the upgraded TubeBuddy license, the paid subscription. So if you're looking to upgrade to a paid subscription on TubeBuddy, I highly recommend you join our Facebook group, Small YouTubers Boost, and check the announcement section for a code that will save you 20%. Thanks very much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel to see other great tip videos about TubeBuddy and all sorts of YouTube information that can help you be a greater success on YouTube. And if you found this video valuable, please give it a thumbs up to help other people find it. Thanks for watching.